Human beings, in my opinion, and that's just one model, consist of four quadrants. You can hear it if you don't see it. The physical, the emotional, the intellectual, and the spiritual. All human beings consist of the same. Some of them like to deny it, but that's their problem. When you work with dying patients, and I started originally only with grown-ups, only later when I had children of my own, when I had a boy and a girl, I realized that I'm shying away from dying children because every dying child, every dying boy reminded me of my boy, every dying girl reminded me of my girl, and I knew that I had to do something about it. And then I moved to Larrabita Children's Hospital, where there were mainly dying children, and I saw the children are much easier, much less phony balonies, much more honest, and they're wonderful to talk to, and they're terrific teachers. And I often say there are only three kinds of honest people left in the world. One of them are psychotics. The others are dying patients who have very little time left, so they throw overboard all the baloney. And the other one are young children before we contaminate them. So if you really want good teachers for your own life, work with psychotics or children or dying patients. And they're wonderful, and they give you more than you give them. And I mean that literally. So very briefly, if you work with dying patients, and this is a general rule of thumb, you always start with the physical quadrant. When you start growing up a family and you have a newborn baby, you only take care of the physical needs the first year of life. That is priority one at the beginning of life, and again at the end of life. You take care of the physical quadrant, babies who are lots of loved, hugged, touched, smooched, held, rocked. You give them the foundation of life. They should have physical contact in the whole first year of life as much as humanly possible. Some of you know René Spitz's book on the first year of life, and you know what happens when babies are never touched and loved. They may have nurses around the clock, and they may have all the right formulas, and they die like flies because they don't have that physical, loving, hugging touch. Same thing with terminally ill people. They need to be hugged and touched.